There are many different gorgeous houses with architecture that catches the eye. Outdoor spaces that are very inviting. And a view that is so inspiring. But inside is where style and that personal touch make it a beautiful home. Celebrities put themselves out there to entertain fans and support their personal advocacies. But in their homes is where their true personalities find sanctuary in a safe and personal space. Style accents and decor are not only there to pretty up the interiors. Most of them hold sentimental value that keeps famous personalities grounded in their busy lives in front of the camera and large audiences. From travel pieces and photographs to precious gifts and striking artwork, we will take a look at the homes of two celebrities whose personal touch brings style and character to their living spaces. This belongs to a nomadic individual who decided to plant roots in the Philippines. It's very telling of the taste and lifestyle of host, model, and environmental advocate Marc Nelson. These are very indicative of Marc's life, and the different pieces are grouped together in vignettes to tell a visual and tangible story that is very personal to him. The footprint of Marc's house is very intimate, so it helps that he has a high ceiling and wonderful lighting fixtures with organic shapes to soften what is actually a heavily decorated space. Displayed in the den, which acts as a miniature entertainment space, Marc's world map adds a warm vintage touch to the space. And it has white pins for where he has lived and the red pins for the places he has visited. He's always so excited to mark this map and fill in his bucket list. The terrace is just off the living room, extending the living space to the outdoors, with a water feature that was shipped directly from Morocco. The light fixture above is a gift, and it's also from Morocco, adding authenticity to the space's striking Moroccan feature in the home. Photos are always the easiest way to time travel, and each photo is a conversation piece that Marc is always happy to talk about. Decked on palatina with rich stains, this accent wall is what Marc considers to be a genuine design concept that amplifies his love for travel and social gatherings. He also meant for the kitchen and the dining room to be one social space because he loves to cook and entertain. This is where stories can be told and new memories can be made with friends and family over delicious meals, coffee, or smoothie, and dessert. Even the staircase and the landing are decked with travel items and collections, with more stories that help you learn more about what kind of person Marc is. Such as fondness for turtles, which is shown by all the turtle figurines that are gifted to him. His favorite turtles, however, are his pet turtles, Apple and Om. And in the Africa room, which is Marc's guest room, the African theme is made authentic with paintings and sculptures from African artists. And Marc's mom stays here when she visits, and she wakes up to a row of elephants that fill up the top shelf. This is actually her father's collection from Burma, which she passed on to Marc. Each elephant is carved from different kinds of wood, which is very telling of a man who has immersed himself in different cultural settings and has brought them into a very eclectic home. The primary bedroom takes up the entire third floor, bright and airy, and that's what Marc wanted to feel, as if he was always on vacation. The floating bed designed in collaboration with Chris Laxon of Habitat, and the ensuite bathroom is comparable to that of a glorious hotel. The balcony and the pocket garden is the most important space on this floor because this is where Marc allows himself to still be outdoors in the city with a space to meditate, read a book, and just chill. This particular space describes Marc's desire for nomadic living within the urban jungle of Metro Manila. One of Marc's favorite pieces in the house is an antique clock from Zanzibar. In his own words, it reminds him that time is an ongoing thing. What we make of it is what is really important. Since Marc has already called many places around the world his home, seeing all of his keepsakes from his travels is what makes him feel at home. His style is that of a storyteller, and it is an ongoing creative process, for each new piece has a story to tell, and each space is indicative of how Marc lives his life. Forever the adventurer and the curious traveler, embracing different cultures and creating a modest nest that is truly a nomad's home. Some exteriors offer a peek of what is inside, but in the case of Tim Yap's home, the facade of his home conceals many, many surprises. It is like a cocoon cradling something beautiful that continues to evolve within its walls. Designed by visual artist and architect Carlo Calma, this home stands like a sculpture, with a circular installation on the facade complementing the moon-shaped door at the entrance and the initials TY open to reveal a very lunar-inspired space. The gray and white tones are very easy on the eye. A clean and sleek kitchen, a gray couch with a planet-like rug, bold installations and accents all around. It is a teaser of what is to come when you arrive at the second floor, where all the art takes over. Tim Yap is an art collector and a very sentimental one. He acquires art and he is given art, and his home is an endless visual assault of the senses, but in a very good way. Covered in art from floor to ceiling, some are even jumping out of the walls. Local and foreign masterpieces live harmoniously under one roof. Carlo Calma's minimalist approach gave Tim the perfect canvas to allow his maximalist personality to spread throughout the house, making each space a moment, each piece a highlight, and each dwelling unforgettable. Tim learned more about himself as he allowed his ideas and interests to fill his abode. It all began with a vision to build in what Tim likes to call the Man on the Moon house. A fascination that he has had with the moon since he was a child led to this concept of having a bright and shiny house. So when he steps out into the balcony, he will really look like a man on the moon. This is officially Tim's house that he built from ground up. He's lived in many condos before, but this is the first time that he has created a home for himself. One that he just doesn't come home to sleep, to pack, and to leave behind for work. Tim's home already looks like a dream, but he says that this home is always evolving, just like his dreams and just like himself. So while there may be many changes in the future here and there, it will still have Tim's authentic Yaparazzi personality all over it. Sometimes you think you know a person, and that's how many feel about famous people and celebrities on TV. But the celebrity homes that we just visited are the prime examples of making a house a home, making it yours by filling it with personal items that remind you of your success in life, the goals that you have achieved, and the dreams that have yet to come true. And that's what makes a house a home, a reflection of who you are, where you've been, and what keeps you grounded, and of course, what makes you very happy.